Welcome to this new section on creating titles in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now I want to just get clear one thing. This is actually a lecture that has been updated. I'm recording this about 6 or 7 months after the release of the original course, because with the latest edition of Creative Cloud, Adobe Premiere Pro 2017, we are on the 2017.1 release, they have made a drastic change to how titles are created. Now, I want you to know that if you're not using this release, you can continue with the following lessons, which go over how to create titles in all of the previous versions of Adobe Premiere Pro, whether you're using 2017, the non-2017.1 release, 2015, before that, or even CS6 or before. We created titles with something called the title creator. But now they've changed everything. So if you are taking this course and you already watched those other lessons, but you're confused, well, this is the lesson for you. And if this is the first time you're getting to this section on titles, then please watch this lesson if you're using this version of Premiere Pro. And then in the future lessons, they might not make as much sense to you. So you might have to skip a couple of the next ones because they refer to the older version of Premiere Pro CC. So let's get on with it and let's talk about the main changes. And right now I'm creating titles for this little mini course on photography. So before, what we used to do was click this new title button or new item button and find titles. There was a title option and that would appear in our project file over here. Well, that's no more. But what you'll notice is in our tools panel, we have this little type tool, completely brand new to Premiere Pro. Never had that one before. We also have, if you go up to Window, what's called the Essential Graphics panel. So go ahead and click open that, and you'll see that we have these presets, or you can create a custom title from scratch. Under Browse, you have all your presets, and then under Edit, this is where you would either edit a title you've created or create a brand new one. So there's a few different ways to create a brand new one, but let's just start with what's in this Browse panel. So if you go down to the drop down underneath Essential Graphics, you'll have different options such as captions, credits, graphic overlays, lower thirds, and if you click on any of these, you'll see that there's different presets. And to use any of these, we can just click and drag it down onto our project, onto the new sequence above our video clips. It will take a little while for it to load. That's something that I've noticed. Once you drag it down, it takes a little bit of time to load. It must just be gathering all that data to bring it up to speed. Okay, there we have. And it looks like it's using a font that I don't have, which is really interesting. So since we're on Creative Cloud, if you don't have a font that they're using here, you can choose to sync from Typekit. Typekit is a part of Adobe Creative Cloud. So I'll say sync, I'll say okay, and now it's all synced. So now let me turn off my audio. If I play through this, it has this animation already, which is really cool. So you can go through and check out the different styles and animations that you have going for their presets. Now, how do we edit this? When you click on this, what you'll notice is the Essential Graphics panel changes from Browse to Edit, but also over in our Effects Controls, we have these shapes and text added to this clip. And that's really the difference with how titles were created before versus now. Now, titles are kind of like an effect applied to a clip. So since this is a preset, it has all these shapes, and if you go to the effects controls, we can turn off this eyeball, and it will turn off all of those shapes. You can see them turning on and off. And then with the text, we can click over here. We can even drop it down, and you get all of these options for adjusting your text. We're not going to play around with the effects controls panel that much for our titles. What we would do here is add motion, and you can see that there are some keyframes here that are used to create this motion of the title. It's getting a little too far ahead of ourselves, so let's back up just a minute. So to edit this text, what we actually do is just click right in here in our program window, and we need to use the type tool to edit our text. You can see as soon as I chose the type tool, the text was highlighted in red. We can click right here on the program monitor, and now we can type in whatever text we want. So I'll put my name there. And this is one of the best things about the change from the old Premiere Pro titles. And at first I was playing around with this and I was like, oh man, is this really better? But then I realized that it's just much more efficient to be editing titles in the program monitor compared to opening up in a new window, which was the old way to do it. So how do we actually edit this text? So we can select it all, and then we would actually, or you could just kind of click on it up here. So these are different layers. So these are all the shapes for this preset. It's a little bit confusing if you've never played around with this, but these are all the shapes. But if we click on the text, it highlights all of it. And then down below, if we scroll, we have all of our different options. So first we have our align and transform properties. So if we want to align it to the center of the frame, if we want to align it vertically to the center, we can do that. I'm going to undo that. We can move it around with these buttons right here, just clicking and dragging or clicking and inputting a specific number. We can change the anchor point of the text right here. We can change the scale. And it looks like my link is not set, so it typically your scale lock is going to be on. You could increase or decrease the scale. Or as you saw, if I want to stretch or squeeze it, we can do that by unlocking. Okay, we can rotate it with this button right here, and we can change the opacity. There are master styles that you can create once you've, say, you've created a specific style for your brand with the size, with the font, with the position, with the fill, stroke, and shadow that you like. You can actually create a master style and just apply it to new text and new projects, because this actually saves from project to project. Down below, you have your text options, which is your font choices. So here we can go in, change our font. Let's just choose Avenir, one of my favorite fonts. You have your font styles. Let's make it bold. And not all fonts are going to have different styles. This is also where you can change the point size of your text. So it's another option for changing the size of your text. Here's your alignment. If you want to left align, center, right align. If you need to indent, leading, kerning, all of those options are right here. Your baseline shift, if you want to move things up or down. All of your options that are in basically any standard text editor in your Adobe programs are right here. The other thing here is your fill, stroke, and shadow. Now, these are a little bit different than with the previous version of Adobe Premiere Pro. You have a fewer stroke options. Before, you could change the stroke from an inner stroke to an outer stroke or a center stroke. Now it's just an outer stroke. By default, it's not going to be on most of the time, but you can see here, this is the fill color, and that's the main color of your text. You can turn it on or off and you won't see your text. But if we want to change our fill color, we can click on that white block and change it to just really any color we want. And then we can add a stroke by just checking this on and increasing the size of our stroke. And say we want to, let me just make this really big so we can actually see what's happening. Say we want to just have a stroke without a fill, we can just turn off our fill, which is not my name, but the actual font. So the last thing, I changed to oblique, that's fine. The last thing is the shadow. If we do want a shadow, you just click on that button and you can make any adjustments to your shadow that you have here. You got your opacity, you have the angle, you have the size and the distance from your text. You can play around with that. It kind of comes with a standard style, which I like. So that is the text editor, and you can see that when I click off of it, it goes away from the essential graphics panel. You just have to click back on to bring it back up. So that's all great and good, and now we can take this title, we can even copy it if we want by just Control C and then going to the next part of your video and pasting it, and now we still have the same title. Or you can just option click and drag, and that's going to take you to, it's going to actually just duplicate that title. And now the cool thing, and this is one of the things I love about this version of the title creator, is say we want to change this title up. Instead of saying Phil Ebner, we want it to say something else. We can just change this, say whatever, camera. And it doesn't change the original one. That was a problem, or maybe it was a reason why they did that, but in the previous version of Premiere Pro, if you copied a title and then you change something in the text, it would change it for the actual title itself. So all instances of that title that you created, it would change. And that's one other difference between this version of the title creator and before. Before, our titles actually showed up in our project panels as like an asset, but now it's not an asset, it's just on our timeline. And it's good and bad, because now we can't find it in here, which everyone was used to, but even after playing with this for just a few days, I feel like this is much, much better, much more efficient. So that's how we created a title with the actual presets. How do we go ahead about and create a brand new title from scratch? I'm just gonna delete all of these. There's a couple different ways. The easiest way probably is just to take your type tool and click on your video and start typing. What is also cool about this version of the title creator is that it takes the previous assets or the previous style that you use and it uses it for this title, which is great, because before, when you created a new title, it would start with some funky font with some funky size and you have to redo it every time. Now, if you're working on a project and you have your colors and everything set, every time you create a new title, it's going to use those same style. So now when I did that, you'll see that it opens up here in the essential graphics panel again. It has all the different options that we have, and it was asking me to save this style, but I'm not going to do that right now. The other thing that's different here is that we can add different layers of text. So if we have this text selected, we can go ahead and click again and create another layer. And up here in the essential graphics panel, you'll see that we have two layers. So these are our two text layers, but down here on our sequence, it's just one sort of file or one asset. So that's another thing you have to get used to, that you can put multiple things in one title, which is kind of similar to what we did before. It's just a little bit different in how we go about editing them. So now we can go to either one and edit them individually. So we can go to the high text. Let's make sure that we have it selected. I'll have to select all of that text, and now we can change the size. We can move the position, and we can change the position either with these options up here, or we can go back and take our selection tool and just move it around. We can click on the edge and increase or decrease the size, and it's locked in proportion so it doesn't stretch or squeeze, which is also nice. And we can also rotate it from here by hovering over the corner and clicking and dragging. So let's move these around, and say we want to add a shape layer behind either of these. We can do that through our essential graphics panel. There's this new layer button up here, and this is the other way to create new text too. If you click that, you can choose text, vertical text, rectangle, ellipse, or from file. From file is cool because then we can actually add an image to our title graphic, such as a lower third or an intro title, and you can just find that on your computer. Let's just click rectangle. A rectangle appears, and we can move this around. We can stretch it, make it the right size. How do we make it go behind this text? Well, we actually use this kind of like a project or a sequence where these are different layers, and we can just click click and drag them beneath the other ones. So the one on the bottom is the one behind all of the other ones on your actual video. Here we can change the fill color, we can do all of our standard edits to shapes like we could with our text too. Play with the opacity if we want to make it a little less opaque. Here you can also change the position up here if you don't want to click and drag around on your actual program window. And so just to show you, if I click new, new text, we have this new text option that appears, and it's using the same style as before, so it's really big. So we're going to shrink that down, and that's another way to create your new title layer. To delete a layer, you have to click in your essential graphics panel on that layer and delete it. Press delete on your keyboard. If you click in your program monitor or your program window and you just click on your text and then you press delete, it won't delete. You actually have to click on it in your essential graphics panel and then click or press delete to delete it. So that's basically how we use the essential graphics panel and the new version of Creative Cloud. I'm going to follow this up with a quick lesson on how you add motion to your titles. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you there.